I mean, that's a great feeling. I know we started something, but I didn't know it was that big. I know I see a lot of guys in China handling the basketball, and they are really, really good. But we see that the freestyle made a big influence over here in China.
Hey, my name is Eric Broadway Jones, and I've been a member of the world-famous Harlem Wizards for the past 19 years. In my time with the Harlem Wizards, I've been fortunate enough to travel around the world to be able to entertain fans with our special brand of basketball, trick hoops, and alley-oops.
We do it in a fun, interactive way with the music, the dancing, the dunking, and all types of fun stuff. We just show people how to have a good time in a positive way, so you're going to be the all ball if you like this. You're going to be the all ball when you come to our show.
The crowd can expect a lot of different laughs, a lot of dancing, and a whole bunch of crazy dunks and half-court shots at the game. And I predict that the Harlem Wizards are going to win at the end of the night.
Yo! Game time! Let's do it!
Describing some of the Wizards. Crazy.
That's real crazy.
Somewhat bully, but not a bully. Bully, you know, typical bully.
Lunatic!
I'm more of a calm, laid-back guy. I don't know what these guys are talking about. I'm crazy. I don't know. No, but really, I'm wild. I'm zany. I like to have fun. I like to get in the crowd. I like to touch people, get up close and personal in your face and have some fun. That's what I'm about.
And that made number 9. So while I'm over here in China, I'm looking to break number 10 so I can make it double figures.
What I excel in is being happy and having a lot of energy, and I love to dance and make people happy, and I just enjoy myself every day I wake up, man. Just love it.
Broadway is one of the most synonymous places in New York City, so the name kind of just stuck because when I get on the court, it's like the lights turn on and the personality turns on. It's, you know, it's definitely who I am.
So we have some players that are great leapers. We got some players that are charismatic, funny. We have some players that are really good basketball players. When you combine all those personalities in one, I mean, it's magic.
I was competitive. I'm very, very competitive. I love to play basketball. I coach. I teach the game. I train kids. I'm always watching basketball. I'm a basketball junkie. I love it. And the transition to becoming an entertainer was probably more difficult for me than most because I didn't see myself in this line of work. But to go out to a game and to be able to see a kid in the top rafters of the bleachers smiling, I said that I can have an impact. And I said, if I can get really good at this, you know, I can use this to, in my small way, change the world.
Well, he's a basketball junkie, and I love basketball also, but he pushed me further to be a better man. Family is probably the highest thing to me because my family, growing up, I didn't have a father. You know, when I became a father, I put that probably the highest I've ever put anything in my life, higher than basketball.
Anytime I go into an arena and I see the smiles on the kids' face, the parents, the families that come out to support us, it brings me a certain kind of excitement, and I have to reach deep down inside to pull all the stops out. This is something that I love. I mean, you just gotta love this.
Whatever you put this jersey on, you can be the most talented guy in the world. You can jump the highest. You can have phenomenal tricks, all these things. But if you don't care about other people's happiness more than you care about yourself, if you don't truly love kids and family and being a selfless individual and being able to fix problems on the fly, this job is not for you. That's the biggest difference, our heart. Your heart has to truly be in this job because you will get exposed If you come in just to try to make money or be famous or all these different things, you won't make it here.
So in a leadership role, I think it's really, really important to make sure that we have the right people here representing the Harlem Wizards brand.
China, getting these photographs for the fans. You know we love our fans. This is what we do.
Confused on how reserved they were. You know, you tell them to clap, you know, they
some of the cultures of China is more so quiet. I'm just gonna.
They're shy, but I feel like you have to find a common ground with them. You have to find something in common with them to get them to smile, get them to laugh.
Give them hopes and dreams to one day, you know, do what I do.
We are very much like a family-oriented team. We hands-on with the crowd. We're not gonna be out there. You get to touch us, you get to talk to us. We're not shying away from the crowd. And I think that's the experience you get from the Harlem Wizards, that the crowd is always into our game. Whether they come in on the court, whether they clapping for us, whether we even bring somebody on the court to do a dunk, but we always interacting with the crowd.
We are gonna show you how to be happy, how to let your hand out, how to just have a good time and not worry about somebody laughing at you or saying, why are you so happy, why are you doing this? We're gonna show you, we put you in a position to say, you know, you wanna dance too, get up and dance. You wanna smile, you wanna run up and give us a hug, give us a hug. You wanna autograph, you wanna take pictures, it doesn't matter. Come to Happyville, everybody's welcome.
I want to make sure that they understand that I want to embrace the culture of China and respect that and accentuate that. Whether it be learning the language or just smiling and breaking down the barriers that people think, you know, it's okay to interact, it's okay to smile, it's okay to have fun. Having respect for the way they do things, but also introducing the way that we do things, kind of mixing the two. So understanding who they are, introducing who we are, and then from that, maybe we move the dial a little bit. Biggest thing is be able to influence culture and families and the young people, especially coming up in the country. You change the mindset and you change the outcomes. So maybe the next generation of Chinese basketball players or youth in China are influenced in some small way by what the Harlem Wizards have done here in the last 10 to 15 years.
It's a bunch of crazy guys who like to have fun and give out some free stuff. That's just who we are, the Harlem Wizards. We're here, we're happy, we're excited. Want to see some dunks or some dancing, baby?
护栏呀、杂耍呀，等等等等，就是球迷很喜欢看的，包括咱们球的这些东西，能够以一个比较诙谐的方式，一个喜剧的方式，向话剧一样呈现给观众，而且特别注重这种与观众的互动，我觉得特别好，就很有爱的一个赛事。
还是很多观众是没有见过这些表演，会特别嗨，特别好玩。所以我觉得这个在中国的不管是一二线城市还是三线城市也好，是一个非常有市场的，而且是大家都希望能看到的。